And the Bible said, after that, Eve gave birth to Cain's brother. And Abel took care of flocks, and Cain became a farmer. Abel was a shepherd. He was a keeper of sheep. Cain was a farmer. He was a tiller of the ground. Hear me? Psalm 124 verse 1 says, the earth is the Lord's, and the fullness thereof, the world and all that dwell therein. There is nothing that you have, nothing on this earth that does not belong to God. And the time came for these two people to present their harvest thanksgiving in the journey of life. We have been journeying from January 1st, and we are about to cross over. What can you stand before God like Ezekiel and say, God, this is what I have done for you? Hello?
Amen.
Has God not been faithful? Has God not been faithful? Some people died this year that are even more holy than us. God kept us alive. The Bible said in Hebrews chapter 4 verse 16, Hebrews 4 verse 16, let us stand boldly before the throne of grace that we might obtain mercy. When you stand there, what will you tell? When Isaiah went to Ezekiel and said, thus hear the Lord, you are to die. Ezekiel said, I cannot die. Why? One, I've been faithful. Every year I give God quality thanksgiving. The two of them, Cain and Abel, they were in the presence of God. Two of them. But how quality is your thanksgiving? The Bible said, look at it, in verse 3. Later Cain brought some food from the ground as a gift to God. Anyhow, his thanksgiving was lackadaisical. Anyhow, let me just give God anything. Not until you understand that what I have come here to do is very spiritual. We must come before his presence with what? A heart of thanksgiving. There is nothing we can give God. God first desires the purity of our heart. In Psalm 24 verse 3 to 4, Psalm 24 verse 3 to 4, the Bible says, who can ascend unto the high hills except he that has a pure heart and a clean heart? God was not interested in the rams, the cows, the yams, or whatever. God was interested in the state of the heart. Because there's nothing in this earth that does not belong to God. Verse 4. Abel brought the best part. Can you see? Cain brought some, just anyhow. But Abel brought the best part from some of the firstborn. Can you imagine? He selected. After he has done the first selection, from the firstborn, the most quality ones, he went again and picked the best. If I were you, the first thing I will give God today is myself. Paul, to Paul, the Bible said he gave himself and gave his pocket. He said, I spend and what? I'm here this morning to exhort you. The word thanksgiving can be defined as an expression of gratitude, especially to our Almighty God. Harvest is all about thanksgiving. An attitude of gratitude to God will always culminate into an attitude, an attitude of greatness. Because appreciation to God is an application for more.
Yeah.
One day the Lord said to me, then I had two cars remaining. He said, that particular one, go and give it to a pastor. We're studying open heavens and about giving. And I went to my wife. I said, this is what the Lord is saying. And I went to my daughter. This is what the Lord is saying. They told me that that is the same message they received. I said, we should go and pray. And they got the same name. On the day I was to go and give him, I took the vehicle to car wash. And I wanted to go with the other one. The Lord said, no. I said, go and give this man. He's no more yours. Don't, if you are coming, use your leg. And me and my wife will went there. And this was a man that has never bought a vehicle or a motorcycle in his life. He had a motorcycle given to him by a church member. And I went there. And what I was telling my pastor Iyadeboye, my father in the Lord, is when you are giving somebody something, please thank the person for accepting it from you.
That is it.
Are you hearing me?
Yes.
And I gave it to him. And I said, thank you, sir, for accepting it from us. Mama will tell you